This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about approximating square roots with the squeeze method. So here's how the squeeze method works. Let's say that I'm told to approximate the square root of 7. Now, the square root of 7 is an irrational number, so I can't write it perfectly, but I can try to come close to it. And here's how I'm going to do it. I'm going to look for the next largest perfect square beyond 7. So counting up from 7, I could think of 8, but 8 isn't a perfect square. The next number is 9, and 9 is a perfect square. So since 7 is less than 9, the square root of 7 would be less than the square root of 9. And now I'm going to look on the other side of 7. I'm going to look for the next smallest perfect square that's less than 7. Well, 6 is not a perfect square, 5 is not, but 4 is. So since 4 is less than 7, the square root of 4 will be less than the square root of 7. So now I've got the square root of 4 is less than the square root of 7 is less than the square root of 9. Since 4 and 9 are perfect squares, I can take their square roots. That means I would have, instead of the square root of 4, I'm going to have 2 is less than the square root of 7 is less than, and instead of the square root of 9, I'll just have 3. So this means that the square root of 7 is somewhere between 2 and 3. So since I'm looking for a number that's going to come close to the square root of 7, I look in between the numbers 2 and 3, and right in between those two numbers would be 2.5. So I'm going to take 2.5, and I'm going to square it. When I square 2.5, I get 6.25. Now, 6.25 is less than 7. So the square root of 6.25, or 2.5, would be less than the square root of 7. So now I can write 2.5 is less than the square root of 7 is less than 3. And I'm going to repeat my process again. I'm looking for a number between 2.5 and 3. So I'll try 2.7. I'll take 2.7 and I'll square it. When I square 2.7, I get 7.29. Now 7.29 is greater than 7. So what I'm going to do is write 2.5 is less than the square root of 7, and the square root of 7 is less than the square root of 7.29, or 2.7. So I'm looking for a number between 2.5 and 2.7. So we'll try 2.6. I square 2.6. When I square that, I get 6.76. 6.76 is less than 7, so the square root of 6.76, or 2.6, would be less than the square root of 7. So 2.6 is less than the square root of 7, and that's less than 2.7. Now, if I only have to find an approximate square root of 7 to the first decimal place, it's going to be either 2.6 or 2.7. And I'll decide that by looking at the squares of those two numbers. Well, 2.7 squared is 7.29, and 2.6 squared is 6.76. 6.76 is a little bit closer to 7 than 7.29 is. So 2.6 would be an approximation of the square root of 7 to one decimal place. If I have to go two decimal places, let's just do that to make sure that you understand this process. I'm just going to repeat the process. I'm going to fine-tune it a little bit. I'm now looking for a number between 2.6 and 2.7. Well, I'll try 2.65. If I square 2.65, I get 7.0225. And that's greater than 7. So that means that 2.6 is less than the square root of 7, is less than the square root of 7.0225, which is 2.65. Let me fix this over here. I wrote it wrong. Okay, so I'm looking for a number between 2.6 and 2.65. Now, I could go halfway between those two numbers, but since when I squared 2.65, I got really close to 7. I got 7.0225. I'm just going to try 2.64. Oops, I didn't mean to write that yet. So 2.64 squared is going to be 6.9696, and that's less than 7. So now I can write 2.64 is less than the square root of 7, and that's less than 2.65. So now if I want to find an approximation for the square root of 7, an approximation to two decimal places, it's either 2.64 or 2.65. So I'll look at the squares of both of those numbers. And 2.65, when I squared it, came really close to 7. So 2.65 is going to be the approximate square root of 7. And once again, I could continue this. I could go out three decimal places by looking for numbers between 2.64 and 2.65. But at this point, I think you understand the process, so we'll leave it at that. Take care. I'll see you next time.